Welcome back, students, and now let us start with creating the objects for the image targets. So for this, come to Unity now. So we are going to start with Unity, and in Unity the first thing we want to do is we had downloaded the database. Let us import the database into Unity. So to import that, you have to come to assets here, import package, and choose custom package. So if you come to Sattvic Unity Aish AR book and in scanned drawing book here, you can see we had downloaded this AR book database Unity package in the last session. So select this and click open. So now it will ask for the import Unity package. So it will import all the images. So here select all and click import. So all this stuff will be imported into Unity. So once it is imported into Unity, the next thing is we have to now start creating the image targets. So to create the image target, now in AR book scene we have AR camera, and we have to now add the image target. So to add image target, select AR camera, then go to game object, and in Euphoria engine click on image target. So when we click on image target, this is going to add a image target here. So once we add the image target, first let us name this. The first image target that we are adding is S capital sun, I capital image, T capital target. This is sun image target. We have added the sun image target. And here image target behavior, we set to from image. Click here and you can choose from database. And when you select from database, in database, now we will see this AR book database. It appears here. If it has been imported correctly, you have to see your database here. Select this, and as soon as you select it, you will start seeing the image over here. But this image is right now set to car. So click here, and from this list, choose sun. So we are going to choose sun and add sun as the image target over here. And see that if this image target should be a child of AR camera. So when you add image target, if you have selected AR camera, then it will automatically be the child of this sun image target. Now, as soon as this image target appears, what we want a sun to pop up. So for sun, what we shall do is, we shall create now a 3D object. So select this sun image target, right click and choose 3D object, and in 3D object, let us choose sphere. So when we choose sphere, the sphere is added over here. You can see the sphere added. So let us see this sphere and let us reduce its size. So right now this sun is very big. What we shall do is, if you come to transform window here, along the x-axis set its scale to around 0.3, and along the y-axis set its scale to 0.3, and along the z-axis also if you set it as 0.3. So now we are seeing the sun as a small object. So it has become very small. So what we shall do is, we shall change it to 0.5 now. So make it 0.5. And when we are using it, instead of this being a sphere, what we shall do is, let us make it little flat. So that's why what we shall do is, along the z-axis, change it to 0.1 or 0.2. So when we make z-axis, it will be flattened like this. Okay. So we have the sun object here. Name this as, we shall give it as the name as sun M capital model. So give it the name as sun model. Now go to file and choose save to save this. So after this, our next job is to add right material to this. So to add material to this, now come back to your project window, and in assets, you already have four folders here: editor, resources, scenes and streaming. So we have four, okay, streaming assets. So we have four assets here. Right click in this asset window, click on create and create a new folder, and name this folder as materials, M A T. So we will name it as materials, so that we are going to create a material for our object sun. So double click materials, and in it right click, choose create, and create a material. So you have material here. Name this material as sun. Okay, S is capital, sun. And after naming it as sun, now let us add a color to this. So right now it is white. Just click here, and for this correct orangish red color, let us, I will give you a hexagonal code so that it remains the same color. Type FDB here, one second. In color you type FDB, then 813FF. Okay, this color has been chosen. Okay, choose this color, and once you have selected this color, now the next is we have to apply this material to our object. Now next here, drag this sun material from here onto the sun model here, or to the model in the scene. So as soon as you apply it, you can see the sun material has now been applied. Right click and rotate, and you can see the sun material has now been applied to. Shift and middle mouse is for panning. Shift and middle mouse pan it. So we can see the sun material has been applied. So let us place this sun a little to the top. If we want to move it along the y axis, you can see here, let us set the position along y to 1. Okay, we have set the y position to 1, and so we have the sun here. The next thing what we want is, so in our last project also, we just added a model and we added animation. But this time in this project, let us try to add some particle effect. Say for example, here we have sun, and we want some kind of heat wave moving around the sun when the augmented reality object is triggered. We want to create an animated heat smoke. So let us see how we can create it. So now to add particle here, in the latest version, now go to file, choose save it, and now to add the particle, come to sun model here, then right click, and here you have effects. Under effects we have particle system. So select this particle system. So as soon as we select the particle system, you can see the particle moving over here. So now here, to convert this particle system into dust, we have to make a lot of parameter changes over here. So today we shall learn about this particle system in detail later, but right now, to get a ready-made smoke effect, instead of using this particle system, what we shall now do is, now select this particle system. You can see the particle system moving here, and you can see the particle effect applied. You can change so many, if you come to the inspector here, you can see so many parameters can be edited. But right now, instead of editing this and converting this particle into smoke, let us select this particle system, right click, and let us delete it. Now to get the ready-made effect, what we shall do is come to asset store, and coming to asset stores, wait till it connects to the internet. Coming to asset store here, in search you type standard assets. Okay, so when you type standard assets, here you can see standard assets for Unity. This is a free download available. So select this assets over here, click on it, and then this is free. So first time when you are using it, click the download button. See that you are logged into your account. Click on the download button. So this will get downloaded. So this file is around 183 MB. So every time, if you have any problem in downloading it and importing it from the asset store, what I am doing is I am also sharing these assets along with the resources that will be uploaded. So for this, to directly go assess the standards assets, what we shall do is go to game assets, go to game assets, import package, choose custom package. Now here, in your standard underscore drawing book assets folder, you have one standard assets for Unity package. Okay, you select this package and click open. So now this package will be imported into your Unity. So it will show the list of all the items that will be imported. So you can just go through it. And after this, now here when we go through here, you can have various features over here. Select everything, select all, and click import. Wait for the package to get imported. So now here, come to assets folder. Once this asset has been imported, now come back to scene tab here, and in assets, once you have imported it, you will see a standard assets folder. So you can see the standard assets folder here. Double click to open it. This is what has got imported. And in all these standard assets, you have one particle systems here. Select particle system and double click to open it. And inside particle system, you have prefabs. Double click prefabs to open it. And you have various particle effects available over here. Now what we will do is select sun model, select this dust storm and drag it over sun model so that this dust storm is. So now you can here see here this dust storm mobile is grayed out. The reason why it is grayed out is as soon as you added the particle, it is not activated automatically. You can see here this is not activated. So click on this activate button, and when you click on the activate button, this will be activated. And second thing is we want this desktop mobile. Now right now it is only the child of sun image target. Drag this and put it on sun model so that you see this tabbed structure. Now this is the child of sun model. So we have made this the child of sun model. Click the play button here to see the simulation. So you can see the smoke moving around. Okay. So you can see the smoke is getting generated. Right click and rotate and see you can see the smoke getting generated. So stop the playback. Now what we shall do is with shift and center mouse, drag it and bring it to the center here. And now select the move tool, and with the move tool selected, let us drag this to the center of this sun model. So what we will do is come to the transform position here and type 000. So when I type 000, automatically you can see, since this is a child of sun model, this is exactly placed at the middle of the sun. So now if I play it, you can see the dust moving around. So we can zoom it and see it. So we have added a ready-made particle effect here. So stop the playback, go to file and choose save. So to customize this effect, select this desktop mobile, and then in the inspector window here, so you have various options available in this inspector window. And in this inspector window, you have one start color here. Right now, this color is set to somewhat grayish. Now in the start color here, click on the start color here, and in the color picker, give it the same color that we added to the sun. So what was the color we added? FDB813FF. So the same yellowish tint, we shall add it and close it. So now you can see the smoke is changing from orange to gray, and also the initial color is orange and the end color is gray. And also this entire smoke is engulfed in a box as of now. So we want this to be in a sphere. So for that, if you come to the shape option here, so if you click on the shape option, the shape is set to box. Click on it and from this list choose sphere. So when you choose sphere, now actually when you play it, so if you play it, you can see in spherical direction it is moving. And let us stop the playback, and you can see here the scale of the sphere. It is set to 50 0 50 50 x 50 z and 0 y. So let us reduce this to around 10 x 10 y and 10 z. Okay, so what happened now is this has become smaller, this area. So let us make it still smaller. Let us make it, say, for example, 2 2 2, so that it is densely present over here. So you can see here. Now let us play it. So now you can see from the center of the sphere the heat waves or the smoke is moving around. So in this way we have selected the shape to sphere and we have set the size to 2 2 2. With this setting, now go to file and choose save to save this project. So after this, now the next thing is here, let us set the scale to, still we shall make it smaller here. Let us make it 1, 1 and 1. So we have made the decrease the scale to 1. And then after reducing the scale to 1, also in the start end color, if we come here, let us choose the end color as a little, it is showing gray as of now. So now let us, what we shall do is use this color picker and choose the start color itself as the reference color and make this a little darker. So what we shall do is selecting the same color here. So let us just make this same color little darker. Okay. So let us make it slightly darker with the same tint. So we have just decreased the darkness. So then close it. So with this we have successfully created this smoke, and now let us play it and see it. See, the smoke is moving exactly from the center of the sun here. So now stop it. Now the next thing, it go to file, choose save, and after saving it, now our next job now is to test this augmented reality project. And when we want to run this game now we face one real problem. The problem we are facing is we had imported the assets, standard assets. That is, we took the standard assets of Unity, and that version is 2018 version. So because it is a 2018 version, so we imported it. Now the version we are using is 2019. You can see here, the standard assets for Unity is 2018.4 version. So when we use these assets in 2019, we will have some errors. Sometimes some of the commands used in Unity would have become obsolete. So now that's why if you come to Window, General, and if you open the console, you can see here the error message. The error message it is showing is, right now, a function that we use, GUI text, has become obsolete. Means in 2019 version, this has been removed. It also gives you a solution to use UI.text instead. So now select this error and double click on it. So when you double click on this error will open in Visual Studio. And you can see here in Visual Studio, and let us see this class. This is some class called simpleActivateMenu.cs. So this class is not required for our job of generating the particles. So what we shall do now is, select this, that is, these lines here, and let us comment off all the lines so that this, see, add two backspaces in every length. So add these two backspaces in every line so that every line we are going to add this, and we are going to comment every line. So that what happens is, now this entire set of script here will not be executed. So we are not using this script at all. So we are telling the computer to ignore all the lines here, okay, even this public class here. So let us now see, we have commented all the lines in this namespace, and now once we have commented it, go to file, choose save all. So after commenting all the text over here, now come back to Unity and check here. So now you can see we don't have the error. So the error is not being shown. So now let us test it with the camera. Let us play and check it with the camera. The camera is activated. Now I will take the camera. I will bring it over the printed sun image over here. I will hold it like this. Hold for a few seconds. Okay, so see, once I hold it, you can now see the sun appearing along with the smoke. See, you can see the sun appearing along with the smoke. So this is now working fine. So we have successfully created our first augmented reality image over here. So after testing this, now stop the playback. Let us stop the playback and go to file and choose save. So remember, whenever we have an error, what we did was we opened this file and we commented all the lines present inside this namespace Unity Standard Assets Utility. All the lines were commented, so that this simple activate menu.cs is not at all executed. So follow, so you have to make some tweaks like this. This you have to learn from trial and error. So with this, our first image target project is over, and let us next move into the other images. So write down, close this and save the project. Close Visual Studio and save the project.